So I was asked the question, using mathematical induction, prove that n to the power of 3 minus n is divisible by 3 for all n is greater than or equal to 2. Now, mathematical induction is quite a mechanical process, and there's really only three steps you need to remember. The first step is to verify that this statement holds true for a special case of n. Normally it is 1, but in this case we'll choose n is equal to 2. The next step is to verify that this statement holds true for any value of n, and then by induction we conclude that this statement holds true for all positive values of n above or equal to 2. So the first step, we test if it is true for n is equal to 2. So 2 to the power of 3 minus 2 is equal to 8 minus 2, which equals 6. And 6 can be written as 3 by 2. And because 6 is a multiple of 3, it is obvious that it is divisible by 3, so this statement holds true for when n equals 2. The next step, we assume that it is true for n is equal to any positive integer k. So we write k cubed minus k is equal to 3 by some multiple of j, where j is equal to 1, 2, or 3. So j is any positive integer. And for the third step, we prove that it is true for the next value of n, so n equals k plus 1. So with n equals k plus 1, we say k plus 1 cubed minus k plus 1 is equal to, now we have to perform a binomial expansion here, so the first parenthesis expands to k cubed plus 3k squared plus 3k plus 1, and then minus k plus 1. So the negative can expand into the brackets to become minus k minus 1, and I can delete the parentheses here. Okay, so positive 1 and negative 1 cancel, and for convenience I shall rewrite this equation as k cubed minus k plus 3k squared plus 3k. Now this k cubed minus k term we can substitute for 3j. So now we can write 3j plus 3 outside of k squared plus k. And then if I factor out a 3, this becomes 3 outside of j plus k squared plus k. Now, it is important to note that all of these are integers. So j and k are both integers. And we note that when we square an integer, we still yield an integer. And so we note that the sum of integers is still an integer. So let's call this I for integer. So we have 3 times an integer. And of course, any multiple of 3 is obviously divisible by 3. So we have proven that it is true for any value of n. And therefore, by induction, we conclude that this statement holds true for all values of n greater than or equal to 2. So let me write that down. Conclude. Valid for all n greater than or equal to 2. Please give me a like if you found this video useful, and please subscribe to my channel for more free math tutorials. Don't hesitate to ask me any questions using the comments, and best of luck.